morning.
Our focus in this episode is on diabetes. We'll investigate the different types of diabetes and how they are diagnosed. Despite the best efforts of researchers and doctors all over the world, there is currently no known cure for diabetes. Diabetes is a metabolic disorder of the pancreas, a small gland located below and just behind the stomach.
Daily shots, constant finger pricks, and watching what you eat. Sound like a nightmare to you? Well, for millions of Americans out there, they are living this nightmare. My sister, Shannon Turgeon, is one of those million Americans who have type 1 diabetes. Day after day, Shannon pricks her fingers with needles, gives herself shots in the stomach, and watches what she eats. Shannon has dealt with this since she was at the mere age of 4 years old. Through everything, Shannon has done a remarkable job. Many other people in the world, including myself, would not, could not, be able to do what she is able to do on a daily basis. This is Shannon Turgeon, and this is her story.
Aww. This is my girl that's now a big girl. She's 7 years old today. July 29, 2002. Oh, and she just broke her present.
When were you diagnosed with diabetes?
I was diagnosed when I was 4 in November of 1999.
What are some daily struggles that you live with because of diabetes?
Having to leave class when my blood sugar feels high or low, and just having to be on alert kind of to know like what. If my blood sugar is going to be high or low, and like watching what I eat and stuff during school. I can eat pretty much what anybody else can eat. I just have to do insulin for it, but I mean, like, there's things that I shouldn't eat, like, that are bad for me. Like, it wouldn't be good for me if I had, like, cake or ice cream every single day or whatever. Like, I need to limit myself to, like, foods that have a lot of carbohydrates in them. When I was younger, I was always afraid, like, people would make fun of me, but nobody ever really has, like, especially now that I'm older, like, a lot more people know about it, and, like, nobody really cares. Like, it's, like, a normal thing. If I don't make a big deal out of it, nobody else will.
And are you afraid to tell people about your diabetes?
No, not anymore. Like, when I was younger, I definitely was afraid. Like, I wouldn't even tell, like, my close friends. Like, they wouldn't even know about it just because I didn't want people to know because I was afraid they would, like, treat me differently. But now, it's, like, I've had it for so long that it's gotten to the point where I just don't care anymore. Like, it's more of a burden to, like, keep it from people than to just tell them. So, if they have a problem with it, I don't really care. So.
How are you able to handle a cross with your diabetes?
It's a lot of, like, managing my blood sugar. Like, I have to be careful what I eat before practice, and I have to test my blood sugar before practice, and if my blood sugar feels high or low during practice, I have to stop, even if I don't want to. And I drink Gatorade, like, I sip Gatorade throughout the practice because that has carbs in it, and it keeps my blood sugar up for that. And other than that, I mean, that's pretty much it.
As you can see, it is very hard for diabetics to live with diabetes on a daily basis. However, many people fail to realize that it is just as tough for the parents and family members of those with diabetes to live with the disease as it is for themselves. This is my mother, Susan Turgeon, and this is my father, Kenneth Turgeon. Here, you will hear both of their stories and how they have dealt with Shannon's diabetes over the years.
First of all, when was Shannon diagnosed with diabetes?
Shannon was diagnosed with diabetes November 16th, 1999, at the age of 4 years old.
It was a bad day, that's all I know. I didn't believe that she had diabetes when her mother came home and told me.
When did it hit you that my daughter is not going to live a normal life?
When she was in the hospital, We were there 7 days because it took me so long to figure out how to give an insulin shot.
Oh, I have a normal daughter. I don't feel that she's not normal. I mean, I'm very proud of her with diabetes and not having diabetes. It's just been very difficult for our whole family with having and living with someone who has diabetes. A lot of people don't realize that, you know, insulin's not a cure.
Because I was so nervous and so distraught over everything, they had me practicing giving shots on oranges, and I couldn't get the hang of it. And so she had to be there 7 days because they wanted to make sure that my husband and I were totally comfortable, Shannon's dad and I were totally comfortable with the whole thing. So I think even then I was okay. When it really hit me was 2 weeks later. We were somewhere, and I don't even remember where I was, but her blood sugars were, like, really bad that day. They were going up, and they were going down, and they were going up, and they were going down, and I couldn't figure out how to control them. And it was at that point that I realized, oh, my God, this isn't going to go away at all. I have to deal with this every single day. This is going to be really hard.
How well does Shannon do of controlling her diabetes?
Considering everything, I think she does very well. It's been hard on all of us, her and her mother, and on Shannon, of course.
She pretty much does, you know, a lot of the stuff on her own now. I would like her to do more. However, our new endocrinologist does indicate that Shannon doesn't need to do more, that Shannon does plenty. So she's become really independent. She can give her own injection. With her pump. She tests her own blood sugar. She counts her own carbs.
And how has Shannon progressed from when she first had diabetes to now?
It's been a long road because I remember the days when she was first diagnosed and we had to learn how to, you know, draw up insulin in a needle, give our 4-year-old daughter the shots in her belly and her buttocks. It's very difficult to learn that, and then not being a doctor or medically trained, having to do that was extremely difficult, you know, and for our psyches as well. I mean, having to put a needle in your kid.
The very first endocrinologist that we had, his name was Dr. Duck. He's very well known in Illinois, and probably very well known in the endocrinologist world. He was our very first doctor. His whole theory was, you have to start doing this on your own because you're going to have to deal with this all the time. So, just to back up your question, he also wanted Shannon's dad and myself to know how to do everything too. In other words, he didn't want me calling him all the time saying, Shannon's blood sugar is 500, what should I do? And when I did call him, he would say, what do you think you should do? And it used to annoy me so much because it used to be so aggravating. I wanted someone to tell me what to do, and he wanted me to be able to figure it out on my own, which was really good. At the time, I hated him for it, but now I realize it was the best thing he could have done because of that, I had to learn everything I could without relying on anybody else.
Do you tend to see people treat her differently because of her diabetes?
I've seen a lot of different things, and it's unfortunate. I try not to dwell on it or let her know about it, but
I think when she was little, I used to feel that way because, well, do you want me to tell you a story?
Yeah.
Just looking from the outside, sometimes I see people, looking at different sporting things when she has her Tesla levels and stuff, you know, people giving her weird kind of stares and looks. And
she went to a American Girl craft project, little thing at the library. So she was in this room with all these little girls, and she sat down at a table. And I remember that I forgot to give her glucose tabs in case her blood sugar went low. So I went in before the program started, and I handed her some glucose tabs, and I said, here, take these.